I'm here from the bar.
Very good.
Mr. Chairman, members of the committee, thank you for the opportunity to speak to this bill today. Senate Bill 210 is one of the simpler bills we'll ever have before you in the, in essence, those two things. One, it extends the sunset, which otherwise would end the ability to have the assessment on lawyers. It ends now in 2020, June 30, 2020. It would be extended by 3 years to the end of June of 2023. The Client Protection Fund is one of, I think, the most important programs that the bar offers. The legal profession here in Virginia is the only profession I'm aware of that assesses itself these monies in order to make whole those who've lost money through dishonest conduct of the lawyer who they were working with. And although that's not a frequent occurrence, it does happen. The fund began its assessment back in the mid-90s in the sense of the bar paying money into the Client Protection Fund. And then later, the $25 assessment, which was recommended by the Supreme Court of Virginia and by the bar council, came into being. And it has been $25 a year ever since. And it is paid with deduced payments. What's important that has occurred this year are really two things. One, the $25 assessment that was in place from the beginning will drop to $10 effective July 1 of this year. That is by action of the Supreme Court. And the second thing is, after being in existence some 40 plus years, the fund has finally reached the funding level that the actuaries who've done two studies of the fund said it required in order to be actuarially sound. So we are asking for your support on Senate Bill 210.
Thank you. Are there any questions? Thank you, sir.
I'm new running Deputy Executive Director of the Virginia State Bar, and I'll answer any questions if anyone has any on the Client Protection Fund. It's one of our, as Jack just said, one of the things the bar is most proud of. It goes to help victims of dishonest conduct of lawyers whose licenses are suspended or revoked due to some dishonest conduct. So it helps to protect the public and ensure the bar's core mission of regulation, profession, and protection of the public. Thank you.
Are there any questions? Yes, sir. No, please move the floor.
Second.
There's a motion to report in a second. Any further discussion? There being none, please record your vote on the and the bill reports. Thank you, Mr. Harris. Thank you. And the committee will stand in this.
Yeah, I'll let you know.
All right.
You're just saying.
for the circuit.
For 17.
Okay, what does it say?
Thank you.
Flint? Did you have a Flint?
You can do anything.
Oh. Did they have to be ultrasound or something to get that? Lord, man. You know, thank God, I'm a woman, I've never had to look at it. Remember that guy that got some through the video? You and I kind of Richard.
Get on LinkedIn a lot or something.
It's just like, I think it's a college professor, but that's children. Literally, now one of the challenges is that do you think about the Women's Committee in our, it's been kind of active, and then kind of has a stake, she decided sometimes we'll do this form, that one, that finds out this form, you know, so it's not like, we're just kind of set up for that, so. And you know what, unfortunately in today's society, it's over, you're good at it.
Imagine like a bumbling.
Yes, I think Justin has recommended a amendment, but I'm not really sure.
Not yet, so.
Couple of other years.
need to walk out.
Did you?
Yeah.
That's all you need.